the Lord. Praise the name of Jesus. This is Evangelist Brenda Thompson coming to you today. Today I greet you in no other name than in Jesus' mighty name. The title of my message today is Signs of the Times. My message is taken from 1 Samuel chapter 18, verse 10 to 16, and my reference is Matthew chapter 16, verse 13 to 19, and 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 1 to 5. And David went out whithersoever Saul sent him, and behaved himself wisely. And Saul, please look with me from verse 10. And it came to pass on the morrow that the evil spirit from God came upon Saul, and he prophesied in the midst of the house. And David played with his hand as at other times, and there was a javelin in Saul's hand. And Saul cast the javelin, for he said, I will smite David even to the wall with it. And David avoided out of his presence twice. And Saul was afraid of David, because the Lord was with him and was departed from Saul. Therefore Saul removed him from him, and made him his captain over 1,000. And he went out and came in before the people. And David behaved himself wisely in all his ways, and the Lord was with him. Wherefore, when Saul saw that he behaved himself very wisely, he was afraid of him. But all Israel and Judah loved David, because he went out and came in before him. Please turn with me to Matthew chapter 16, verse 13 to 19. When Jesus came into the coast of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, saying, whom do men say that I, the Son of Man, am? And they said, some say that thou art John the Baptist, some Elijah, and others Jeremiah, or one of the prophets. And he said unto them, but whom say ye that I am? And Simon Peter answered and said, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. And Jesus answered and said unto him, blessed art thou, Simon Barjona, for flesh and blood has not revealed it unto thee, but my Father which is in heaven. And I say also unto thee, that thou art Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. And I will give unto thee the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatsoever thou shalt bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. Please turn with me to 2 Timothy chapter 3. This know also, that in the last days perilous times shall come. For men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, without natural affection, truth breakers, false accusers, incontinent, fierce, despisers of those that are good, traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasures, more than lovers of God, having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof. For from such. Tell them.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Glory be to Jesus. We worship you today, Almighty God. We are living in trying times, and the Bible says that man's heart will fail them because of fear. But today Jesus is still saying to the church, fear not. In verse 10, that at this point in time, that King Saul, who belonged to the tribe of Benjamin and represented the kingdom of heaven, was in the midst of the church prophesying to the congregation, and something delusional was going on at the same time. He was possessed with an evil spirit. The spirit of violence was controlling him. At the same time, and there was a weapon in his hand, a javelin. 1 Samuel chapter 19, verse 9 and 10 gives us the reference. And the evil spirit from the Lord was upon Saul as he sat in his house with his javelin in his hand, and David played with his hand, and Saul sought to smite David even to the wall with a javelin, but he slipped away out of Saul's presence, and he smote the javelin into the wall, and David fled and escaped that night. In verse 11, it tells us that not only was the javelin in his hand, but he was attempting to murder his own brethren in the house of God. At that time, there was a strong move of the Spirit. But it was not of God. It was not the Holy Spirit. The Bible said it was an evil spirit sent from God. What do you do as a Christian when your worst enemy, when envy, hatred, and strife and confusion is coming up against you? Stand in the holy place and escape the presence of your enemies. God has a strategy already in place to deliver you from your enemies. In verse 13, King Saul had developed such a hatred for David because of two reasons. One, he was anointed, the Spirit of God was upon David, and two, David was the next in line to be promoted as king. In the kingdom of Israel, which at that time were 12 kingdoms and not Jonathan his son, sometimes the trap that our enemies have set for us becomes our stepping stone. Please look with me at verse 13. It speaks about demotion. Therefore Saul removed him from him and made him captain, made him his captain over 1,000, and he went out and came in before the people. God will have the last say in your life. Your demotion will become your promotion, and your promotion is still coming. Verse 14, wisdom is the principal thing. Know for sure that the Lord is with you. In verse 15, your behavior and attitude will intimidate your enemies. Please look with me at verse 15. Wherefore, when Saul saw that he behaved himself very wisely, he was afraid of him. In verse 16, it speaks about humility. Humility is the key to your kingdom. Please look with me at verse 16. But all Israel and Judah loved David because he went out and came in before them. Today, I would like to pray a prayer of deliverance. Whether you need deliverance in your marriage, in your finance, on your job, in your community, in your church, in your children's life, deliverance from principalities and powers and throne and kingdom and all demonic attitude. We will continue to pray a prayer of deliverance over your life. Father, I come to you today in no other name than in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray a prayer of deliverance against every contrary spirit, against every demonic spirit, against every murderer, against every situation, and against every circumstance coming up against the life and the livelihood of your people, coming up against their promotion and every negative situation and circumstance today. I pray a prayer of deliverance in no other name today than in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.